In this video, I'm going to share with you my favorite and the most powerful tips on how you can enhance your Freestyle Libre experience. Coming up. My name is Tom. I'm type 1 diabetic. Welcome to Type 1 Talks. On this channel, I share my diabetes journey with you, as well as a lot of videos about diabetes and Freestyle Libre. If you would like to become part of this community, consider subscribing and hit the bell so that you don't miss any future videos. Today, I'm gonna show you the most powerful hacks for Freestyle Libre users. I have been using Freestyle Libre for 2 years. I used both first and second generation, and I picked the hacks that come from both official and unofficial sources, and I picked the ones that worked the best for me. I included links to all the sources that I used in the description below, so feel free to check them out. But now, let's get into it. Tip number one, get the most of your Freestyle Libre reader. Every time you want to switch off the reader, just double press on the home button. This is the fastest way to do it, which saves almost half of your battery life, and you don't need to charge so often. Help save the planet. The reader also includes blood glucose and ketone reader. So talk to your doctor, ask him for Freestyle Libre testing strips for both blood and ketones. I will link them in the description below. And avoid having to carry too many diabetes things with you. Only carry this one little box. The reader also includes insulin calculator. So you can use it to calculate your dosage of insulin based on the parameters that you enter the reader. You need to go to settings and then professional options. Select that you are a healthcare professional and you need to enter code CAA1C. I will put the code in the description below. Once you enter the code, you unlock the functionality for insulin calculator. Then click on the insulin calculator and then you can set up your insulin carb ratio, your insulin sensitivity, your target glucose and so on. If you don't fully understand these things, please have your healthcare professional do this for you. If you use your Libre reader to scan the sensor and you also use your phone, always activate the sensor with the reader first. If you activate the sensor with your phone, the reader will not work. So activate with the reader and then connect your phone. Tip number two, follow these steps to get the most accurate results. Stay hydrated. Drink at least 2 liters of water, Diet Coke, or drink of your choice every day. If you're not hydrated, the interstitial fluid does not provide appropriate and accurate results. If possible, avoid excessive amounts of drugs such as paracetamol or ibuprofen. These can impact the accuracy of readings. Also, vitamin C, we know it's good for us, but excessive amounts of vitamin C can also have negative impact on your readings. So keep that in mind. Rapid temperature changes can cause inaccurate results in a short term. Think going to sauna or swimming in a very cold water. From my experience, very hot environment caused the readings to be a little bit higher and very cold environment caused the readings to be a bit lower. The readings usually stabilize after 15 minutes. But in the moment when the temperature changed really rapidly, this can negatively impact the accuracy of readings. Be aware of compression lows and excessive pressure on the sensor. So if the sensor is subject to excessive pressure, for example, when you sleep on it at night, or you put some kind of cover on it or a tape on it that is very tight and it compresses the sensor, the sensor provides very low readings. So it may happen to you that you wake up in the morning, you check your blood sugar and it's extremely low. And when you check on your glucometer, you realize that the blood sugar is actually normal. This is because you're facing the compression low. This usually comes back to normal in 15 to 30 minutes, but be aware of it. Don't freak out when you wake up with compression low in the morning. Tip number 3. Join the Freestyle Libre Academy. This is a web-based educational program with great content, such as how to get the most out of your Freestyle Libre, advanced functionalities, how to manage your diabetes, and so on. Really great content. The only thing you need to do to access this content is enroll on the UK website. Abbott officially enrolled this program only in UK and Australia. However, with a bit of creativity, you can enroll even if you don't live in any of these two countries. On the UK website, for example, you only need to enter your name, your email, and a UK postcode during the registration. I live in Switzerland and I had no problems accessing the academy. The only thing I had to do, I had to enter a UK postcode. I will include the links to both of the programs, the UK and the Australian one, in the description below. Tip number 4, turn your Freestyle Libre into a full continuous glucose monitoring system. We all know that Freestyle Libre is a flash monitoring system, which means that the data from the sensor are not being instantly sent to the reader or to your phone. However, you can use a third-party device with a third-party app to turn the Freestyle Libre sensor into a full CGM. The most favorite device right now is Miao Miao, and I will link it in the description below. What I will also do, I will link Nerdabetic's video here. He does a great job of explaining how to turn your Freestyle Libre into a full CGM. Another great thing that these apps do is they allow you to scan your sensor and get the data for approximately 12-hour period after the official life of your sensor ended. So although it's not possible to scan the sensor with your reader anymore, you can still do it using these apps. Tip number 5. Do not expect that your Libre readings will be always the same as your glucometer readings. The difference is this. Libre and a glucometer are using completely different method. Freestyle Libre is using interstitial fluid, glucometer is using blood. I will link another video that I made about accuracy of testing, which explains why we cannot expect these results to be always the same and what is causing and driving the differences between the sensor readings and the blood glucose readings from the glucometer. Tip number 6, don't overcorrect and enjoy it. Having the data available 24 hours a day is a great tool to help manage our diabetes. It is also easy to overreact. Whenever we see the blood sugar going up, we want to get it back to range. We want to make it good. So, especially if people are new to CGMs and Freestyle Libre, they tend to overreact, and I did that too a lot. I overcorrected. I just took too much insulin because I wanted to be back in range as soon as possible, and I took too much, so I went to hypo, and then I went up again. I was going up and down, and I still do it from time to time. My tip here is relax, enjoy the functionalities, check the graphs regularly, but make any treatment decisions calmly. It takes a little bit of time to get the blood sugar under control and be in range for, let's say, 90% of the time. But you will finally get there. If you are enjoying my tips so far, please give this video a thumbs up. I still have a long list of hacks to go through, and I will do it in the next video that will be coming out in 2 weeks. For now, I wanted to ask you, please write your favorite hacks in the comments below and share them with the community. I would really appreciate it. I'm looking forward to hearing from you. As a disclaimer, I'm not a medical professional, and on this channel I don't provide any medical advice. I only share my personal diabetic journey for your fun and entertainment, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you for watching, and I'm looking forward to see you in the next video.